What did he? Whoa, that's a big ice chunk. How sweet is that?
Is there no carbide? Oh!
There's no carbides on this one.
All right, two of my favorite snowmobiles are Switchback Assault and XCR. Absolutely love these machines. They both scream fun for different reasons. The Switchback Assault, this guy is your on-off trail machine. This is the 50-50 sled. And the XCR, on the other hand, that's the one if you want to get rowdy, off in the ditches, jumping stuff, start blasting the bumps on the trail. That XCR is for you. That's the one when I'm feeling like a cross country racer, I like the XCR. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna compare these two because a lot of people have that question. What should I get, Switchback Assault or XCR? So we've got an 850 XCR, brand new 2024, Switchback Assault 850. We have a brand new 2024 XCR 850 128, and we have a 23 XCR 136 650, and we're gonna put them all to the test. So I was trying to get the 136, 128, and obviously the 146 Switchback, and we're gonna go out there and we're gonna test them in these different areas and find out where they excel, and hopefully it will help you, help point you in the right direction as to what sled you need. Let's get to it. Tight turns. The first thing that you notice is the both XCRs, they handle them really well. Right now the snow is kind of packy, so the tracks really dig in. They all have Cobra 135s, which are a little bit more rigid as far as side sliding. So with this packy snow, they all kind of hook in real well. The XCRs, both the 128 and the 136, just feel a little bit more stable through the turn. I think they kind of sit a little bit lower than the Assault, and I think that's what gets the Assault in these turns, is they have it, you know, from the factory, it sits up a little bit taller, so it's easier off trail. And I think that's what you notice on trail, is that it's a little bit more inside ski lift. But in general, it's a great trail sled, and with some adjustments, you can make it, you can drop it down to make it a little bit more stable. But overall, I think the XCR is definitely a shine on trail. Long sweeping turns is what we just did, and both the XCRs, they rail through them pretty good. One thing, you know, we have with the 128 is it's an 850, and then the 136 is a 650. And you notice under acceleration, so essentially these long sweepers are cornering under acceleration. And with the 650, you don't feel as, the skis don't feel as light. And as you go bigger, you go with the 850, the 128, I could feel a little bit, you know, lighter steering where it wasn't biting as hard. And then on the Assault, I think that one was probably the lightest, where it felt like, you know, it was almost carrying the skis. And in that situation, that's when I have to like drag the brake to get the front end to settle back down and come down. But in general, I would say the XCR is a little bit better with the coupled rear suspension going around those turns where you're underpowered. All right, big bumps. Those were big bumps. They were bouncing around. The XCRs, I felt like both of them went through it a little bit smoother. The 136, I thought, went through it really well. With the 128, it felt like it was a little bit more rigid through them. But the Switchback Assault, I think, was probably the most rigid. It really felt like it was bouncing a lot, deflecting off of them. And I think the Pro CC rear suspension on the XCRs is a little bit more supple, where the IGX rear suspension on the Switchback is a little bit more rigid feeling, and I think you notice it in there. But in general, that they both get through them pretty good, and I hope that nobody has to ride through that stuff all day long, because that's pretty rough. So the small bumps, they all get through them pretty well. You know, with the stiffer suspension of both the XCR and the Switchback, you feel a little bit more deflecting off the small bumps. Unless you're going extremely fast, those harder impacts, that's where that stiffer suspension comes in. A VR1 through bumps like that, it would eat it up super smooth. But because they're both Switchback and XCR a little bit stiffer suspension, you see the smaller bumps, you kind of feel a little bit more motion through them. But in general, I would say the XCRs handle the smaller bumps a little bit better than the Assault does, but they all are very good through them all. Off trail is, that's Assault territory for sure. It was so nice on the Assault. You know, the thing with that extra length, it just felt so controlled when you're carving. The 136, it felt pretty good. I just felt like it was, like I was edging out on my running boards. Like I was hitting my running boards and kind of being limited to what I could do as far as the carves. The one that was kind of surprising to me, and this may be 850 versus 650, but the 850 128, I was having a really good time on it because it felt like I could really carve that thing sharp and like spin it around. And maybe it's just because of that shorter tunnel, shorter skid, I was able, you know, to maybe have my foot back a little bit further, and that's why it got all like that. I'm not sure, but I was having fun with the 850 128 and the Switchback Assault. You know, the Switchback Assault is by far the best one because you can get into that deep stuff and you're not as worried about getting stuck. And with the uncoupled rear suspension, it was really easy to kind of pull that front end up and have a little bit more playful off trail. And with the 135 track that it has on it, you know, it's not the ideal off trail one, but with the extra length of the 146, you still are getting enough traction to kind of keep that front end light and more playful. So Switchback Assault definitely takes the off trail, and the 136, I think if I had an 850 in there, it probably would have been a little bit torquey, a little bit more playful. But I, like I said, the 850 and the 128 was actually a lot of fun. Definitely not one where you want to get in the deep, deep snow, because, you know, I was in probably 2 feet or better, and you know, I could tell it didn't have a lot more after that, but still very fun. Ditch banging. This is what I live for, ditch banging right there. That was so much stinking fun. I like absolutely love ripping down the ditches like that, and doing it on XCR and Switchback Assault are an absolute pleasure. So the differences in the ditch on both of them. So the XCR, you know, both the 136 and 128, they both just feel a little bit more, what would I say? It's a little bit easier to move them around, so they turn a little bit better traditionally, okay? So if you're trying to like kind of turn yourself into a road approach or something like that, it's easier to just turn yourself into it. They don't carve as well, and I think it's because the front ends feel a little bit lower. They just kind of sit down in a little bit more, so they turn better. So when we did the cornering thing, I noticed like the XCR seemed to corner better. Now when we went on the Switchback Assault in the ditches, that lack of turning that I had on the trails, it came in for carving in the ditches, because I was able to just carve that thing, and you could feel it just so much easier to just kind of maneuver it back and forth through the ditches. And obviously when it came to wheeling, that Switchback was awesome. I mean, you could stand that thing up off all the bumps and whatnot, where the coupled rear suspension of both XCRs would try to keep it down. The one that did wheelie more was the 128, and the 128 had an 850, where the 136 had a 650. So I think I lost a little bit of wheelie power with the 650, but that 128 seemed to like really saw in and stand up good too. So it was pretty decent wheeling there. Overall though, jumping, they all jumped really well. They all jumped well. The XCR felt like the bottoming resistance was a little bit better. The Switchback, it hit a little bit harder. Like when you did hit something hard, You felt it more, I would say, on the hard impact. But for most of that ditch banging stuff that I was doing, it was plenty good for that. So it's a tough one going ditch banging, because I love kind of that controlled feel of the XCR, the stability of it, but I also love that carving aspect of the Switchback, being able to carve. So, you know, to me, it's like if you're leaning more towards carving through the ditch and then not as focused on the jump, I would say Switchback. If you're thinking, you know, regular ditch banging, if you didn't have fresh snow, if it was like more natural turning or normal turning, then the XCR is definitely the one for ditch banging. But sign me up for any other ditch banging test you want to do, because I can do that all day long. Conclusion, Switchback Assault, XCR, I mean, great machines. These both bring a smile to my face. Carvin, I love Carvin. I love being able to jump, love being able to rail down the trail. The Switchback Assault is the one that can do them all. The XCR, on the other hand, is the one that can do ditch banging, jumping, railing through the trails. Awesome. Like, that is the one, if you want to feel cross-country racer fast and you want to push on it that hard, XCR is definitely that sled for you. I was pleasantly surprised how well all of the sleds handled in all of the conditions. They were all manageable in on-trail, off-trail, jumping, you name it. Whatever is your style of riding, that's what you gotta decide. You know, they're definitely better at certain things than the others. And I'll tell you what, I'm just happy that I have them both. All right, guys, if you guys have any questions about any of the sleds or comments, drop them in below. I'll do my best to reply to them. And I'll tell you that this was a fun one. So thank you guys for watching this, because I really, really enjoyed it. So you guys take care. We'll talk to you later.